Shock therapy. When you envision this kind of treatment, scenes of unwilling participants being held down by orderlies and then getting administered an intense electrical shock to the head may come to mind. However, is this the entire story? Also, if this is how this type of treatment is conducted, is it an applicable treatment today? Well, let's answer this and other questions about this therapy and how it affects the brain. But before we do, don't forget to subscribe to our channel, and if you find this episode enjoyable, hit that like button. Now that we've finished some of our housekeeping, today on Brief Brain Facts, we're discussing electroconvulsive therapy. Electroconvulsive therapy, or ECT, formerly known as electric shock therapy, is considered a form of psychosurgery. Unlike other essentially archaic and unused methods of psychosurgery, ECT has been found to be an effective treatment in certain cases. Also, unlike other treatments employed in the mental health field that have been discovered incidentally, ECT was devised under a theoretical framework. It was established as a treatment for a host of serious mental illnesses during the 1930s. But it has been found to have a more specialized purpose today. That's right, ECT is used today to treat previously treatment-resistant depression. Typically, this treatment involves inducing seizures by administering 70 to 130 volts of electricity to the brain. It also involves multiple treatments spread out over weeks. Regarding severe depression, ECT appears to affect the brain's level of norepinephrine and serotonin, but the exact way and even the reason as to why it modulates these neurotransmitters remains unknown. It is no surprise that ECT is a controversial treatment, and those administering the treatment to mental health patients have not helped in alleviating the controversy. Highlighting this point, caregivers to mental health patients have threatened administering ECT unless patients cooperated, using fear tactics surrounding misunderstandings about ECT in order to force patients to cooperate to various orders given by these caregivers. Adding to the controversy are the side effects patients can experience after being administered ECT, the most common being memory impairments. Both retrograde amnesia, which is an inability to recall information learned prior to treatment, and anterograde amnesia, which is an inability to recall information learned after treatment, have been reported. According to researchers, anterograde amnesia improves over time. Retrograde amnesia appears to show complete recovery within about 7 months following the last administration of ECT. And while 7 months means it's not a permanent memory loss, that can still be a long time. Interestingly, when ECT is applied to only one hemisphere, specifically the right, the side effects are substantially diminished. Also, ECT applied to one hemisphere has been shown to be equally as effective as ECT applied to both hemispheres. Regardless, controversy surrounding ECT remains, despite it being a potentially fast treatment for suicidally depressed patients, as it has been shown to work faster than antidepressants. Even the American Psychiatric Association states that, when administered properly, ECT is an effective treatment for severely depressed patients and should be used in treatment-resistant forms of depression. Importantly, ECT should not be administered without an anesthetic and patient consent. It certainly should never be administered as a form of punishment for an uncooperative mental health inpatient. Despite popular belief, ECT is being used in modern psychiatry instead of being employed for a variety of mental health conditions, as was the case during the initial creation during the 1930s and throughout several decades following. It has been relegated to treating those with standard treatment-resistant depression and has been shown to be effective in treating this particular mental health condition. ECT serves as another example in psychology where pop culture, movies, and even its own controversial history have mischaracterized the true nature of the treatment as it is today. While the treatment definitely isn't for everyone, it can be another tool to help treat some of the most resistant forms of depression. What's a shocking thing that you've learned about ECT? Comment below. If you liked what you saw, don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Also, since sharing is caring, share this video with family and friends. Also, head over to our Patreon page to check out content and perks for our membrane brainiacs. And as always, thank you for watching.